Have you ever wondered where your clothes come from?
Imagine working there.
Don't worry, because you are the boss.
Luckiest man in the world!
From the 1970s onward, our economy was hijacked by free market fundamentalists, whose mantra was greed is good, regulation is bad.
Neoliberalism is a political and economic philosophy. It's an ideology. It's understood as a sort of free market theory.
The newest ruler of the world is the World Trade Organization based in Geneva. And yet no one has voted for it. The effect of its policies make it illegal for governments to hinder the profits of big business. This is known as free trade.
Our politicians tell us that trade liberalization is going to make things better.
Liberalization is the process of becoming more liberal or free. Trade liberalization is therefore making trade more free by removing trade restrictions.
And quotas, traditional trade measures. A tariff is a tax charged when a good crosses a border, and a quota is a quantitative limit about how much of an import you'll take. And those limits were then negotiated.
Trade liberalization.
Which begins with the removal of tariffs and duty.
We all like freedom.
Removal of barriers on imported products.
And privatization.
Reducing government's involvement in industry.
Privatizing once nationalized industry. So countries were forced to neoliberalize, promote export-orientated trade.
By specializing in the thing that a country does best, and then trading for the other things it needs, it maximizes its productivity.
The imposition of neoliberal economic policies following the loaning of money from the IMF and the World Bank.
The debt got out of control.
You understand? The International Monetary Fund. It is best to go back to history. We come to 1944. The war is coming near to an end.
At Bretton Woods, New Hampshire, delegates from 44 allied and associate countries arrived for the opening of the United Nations Monetary and Financial Conference.
The key institution set up was the International Monetary Fund. And the purpose of the fund was to have a bank they could turn to for short-term borrowing.
Then you've got to do something. We understand the crisis you're in, and so here is what we think needs doing.
What? Now we lend you some money in a very short time frame at full interest rate to get you out of the bind, and they then impose upon you tremendous restrictions in what you can spend.
And then we reach agreement on the set of measures on the budget, on the exchange rate, on monetary policy, on interest rates, on banks, on maybe privatization.
Many countries in the global south were facing huge and unmanageable debt.
So they got some help from the World Bank.
We're satisfied as to your credit and income, and we're glad to make you the loan.
And they had to borrow even more money just to keep their head above water.
But of course, with those loans comes attached terms and conditionalities. We ask you that you neoliberalize.
Protesters say that you are the chief of a secretive, undemocratic world government, which is actually made poverty worse worldwide.
Mm-hmm.
How do you respond?
Well, I think it's nonsense.
Spend more on paying their debt than they do on health and education combined. It's not a blessing, but a curse.
We should not have on the store shelves in this country the product of sweatshop labor.
Vietnam, a worker in a factory will make $50. A worker in Guatemala, a woman working in what we call the maquiladora, okay, in Guatemala or in other countries of Latin America, will make, you know, $50 a month. So of course, you know, neoliberalism placed all workers of the world in a situation of competition. This is total bullshit, if I.
The law of supply and demand. When supply goes up without a corresponding increase in demand, the price will go down.
Export processing zone, which is an area really that's sort of outside the sovereignty of the nation within which it's built. Foreign companies such as Disney or Walmart or Target or Gap or Nike or whatever it may be can ship in all of the raw materials for their products and really just have that country, whether it's Jamaica or Haiti or Mauritius, wherever it may be, just provide cheap labor for that product to assemble that product and then have it shipped out.
I simply have a basic belief, having been burned out once and really believing this very strongly, that Americans do not want to make shoes. They don't want to make shoes.
The luckiest nut in the world!
We are seeing really quite a great exploitation of work.
These SAC China factory workers range in age from 12 to 13 to 16 years old. They are cranking out Christmas ornaments for Walmart customers.
Superpower left in the world has made its ambitions clear. This is a document of the United States Space Command. It says, the globalization of the world economy will continue with a widening between haves and have-nots. It says only military dominance will protect America's commercial interests.
The ironies of neoliberalism is that we can talk about it and we can critique it, but what we live in is a real world where when you open up a country to the free market, there are some countries within that market that have more power. And one example, of course, is the US, which has heavily subsidized food products, which, you know, no country can compete with. And yet the IMF and the World Bank, based in the US, largely influenced by the US, have the power to demand that those countries do that very thing, even as they subsidize their own goods. So there's a lot of contradictions and complexities.
Now, you shouldn't really take advantage of somebody who's down and out and try to squeeze the last ounce of blood out of them.
Joe Stiglitz was chief economist of the World Bank, so he should know.
Even more. And the unfortunate thing was, those predictions came out to be true.
I found a flaw in the model that I perceived is the critical functioning structure that defines how the world works, so to speak.
In other words, you found that your ideology was not right. It was not working.
Precisely.
I've made a lot of mistakes.
If all of us got it wrong about markets and greed, then what now?
Encourage you all to go shopping.
Got the best lawyers that money can buy, and if there's a case against us, we can fight it. And if one of our trading partners makes up a policy that we're not overly keen on, the threat of sanctions usually helps to resolve any difference of opinion.
Encourage you all to go shopping.
Baby, baby, it looks like it's gonna hail. You better come inside, let me teach you how to jive and roll.
One pack of t-shirts, $4.50. Girl who sold the t-shirts didn't get three. And she's trying to survive in an industry that doesn't care about people. Bangladesh factory, 16-hour shifts, no overtime breaks or benefits. And they'll fire her if she gets pregnant, cause they don't care about people.
Civilizations and the latest neuroscience agree that we're not just selfish, greedy creatures.